Hello, everybody. This is Sonya. I was going shopping today, but that's went by the wayside because it's going to rain or something. So I didn't. Jeremy ran up and just got some bottles of water and stuff that we needed. I got this. Now, I don't know where I got it from. I don't know if I found it or somebody got it for me. And on here, I've seen something I really, really want. I'm going to take those little tiny sequences off here because I want those sequences or whatever. And when I get them, I'm going to show you how to make a crazy patchwork velvet cover for your journals. I just wanted to get these first. I did. I don't know what I'm going to put them in. I wonder how they've sewn, if they've sewn them very, you know, if a machine did it or a person or what. Might have been a person, I think. Oh, they're tiny, aren't they? Probably should wait. I was going to order some on the internet, and I... Aren't they dear little things? Okay. So anyway, that's what I would do with this. Or you could cut out the pieces off here, because this was in the box with the velvet, because it's got velvet on it, as you can see. It's a little bit bubbly or something. I've been cleaning the velvet pieces that someone was going to use. I'm going to have to take it off there. Anyway, I can't get the little sequence off yet because it's going to take too long. So I'm going to show you how to do, and you have done before, but we're going to do one now. We're going to just make the front panel that would go on the front of your book. So actually you could do just do an ordinary journal, like a book. Let me see what I'm trying to say. You can do a there's me two little sequins there. I got two. It was really weird, you know. I seen somebody using them and I thought, I wonder where I can buy some of those. And I thought, you know, that must be, it was easy to find them, so that was good. Now, she was actually putting them onto a brooch she was making, I think. Yes. Anyway, so this is a sort of idea, but this is actually in shiny fabric, you know, like stuff that you use for the other things, maybe not this. But it worked really good. I thought it turned out really well. Now I'm going to make something about the size of this, only a little bit bigger, I think, because I need it to be a cover for... I'll show you now what I'm talking about, because I've... probably confused everybody anyway. So this is a journal that I've just kept because I sort of wanted to. Okay. Anyway, I'm not going to sell me sewing one either. I've decided I'm keeping that as well. My last journal that I made, I can't. I like it. So there's a book bit under here, like a hardcover book, and I've just covered with bits and pieces of a bit of everything. Can't even find it. But anyway, so if you cover your book with a journal or something, with a piece of fabric, if you made a journal out of a book, or you made your journal out of whatever way you like, then we need to make one of these to put on the front. And I think it's easier to do it as just for the front because, you know, you got to get it right. You don't want to have to go and cut off any of these bits that you've stitched on. So I was making it bigger. You know, you probably run over them bits that I've been stitching there. This is not straight, is it? So I'm going to have to cut that down there and take off that piece to make it straight. So what I'm going to do is make a thing that will go on the middle of a journal like that, and so that comes in either side there and there and there and there. And if you want to put one on your book, well, you just do the same thing, and you can make it bigger if you want to. You can make it right nearly to the top, but so I'm going to do one. And I usually make a journal 7x5, so this would probably be the right size for mine if I find the ruler here. I had one a while ago. Always have things a while ago, don't I? You know, they seem to be, they're everywhere, but I've seemed to... Okay, so this has got centimetres, and that's 13. Oh, here we got an inch. I still like to use the inch. So that's 5 that way by 7... and a half. Oh, the book is 5x7¾, maybe. So I think I'd make my panel for the front 7, so it was going on the front of here. It'll go from there to there, so it's just a bit longer than this one. 7 by Four and a half. No, that bit there. You don't count that. It's not in the story. I think four. No, four makes it two. Four and a half. Four and a half. I'm going to write this down by seven. Did I say? I did, didn't I? Four and a half by 7 inches for this size for the front of the book for your front panel. Righto. So if you want to come along and do this with me, that should be fun, I hope, because I'm really wanting to do some more stitching. Now, okay, so we'll put that over there for later, and we'll get some, we need a background piece to start with. I do have a fair bit of that around here somewhere, just put it in there. Righto. I want to make sure too that this is not too heavy what I'm going to put behind it, because I've been taking bits off this bit of, look at that, nice. I forgot what I was saying now. The velvet's thick, this is good. You know, it goes through really good. These are pieces that were gifted to me. They're sample pieces. Excuse me. So I'm going to use that, because you don't want it too tightly woven, because if it's too tightly woven, you're never going to get your stitches into it. I mean, I probably shouldn't use it for that. You could use a bit of calico. Oh, excuse me, I don't know why I'm starting to cough now, waving the bits of fabric around. Where's some calico? I've been using a fair bit of that too lately, and I don't know what to do with it. I am actually making another book somewhere with it. I took it to do something else with it, and I haven't brought it back. I'm just so unorganised, don't I? I think I might use this. I mean, it doesn't bother me, because I've got plenty. I mean, it's not like I haven't got enough. I didn't want it to be too heavy, that's all. Sorry. Oh, my goodness me. What's the matter, Sonya? Oh, dear. Turn around on your chair like that. Okay, right. I've got that linen stuff, but that's too thick too. We don't want anything too thick, okay? It's I can handle this. I mean, I know I can sew it, so I'm sure, you know, you can do it too, or find yourself a piece of calico to put on the background, okay? No, oh, I'm making a mess in here again. Right, so we need a piece. Okay. I'm hoping I can get a bit without having to have that crease in there. So we need 5x7. I'm going to have the crease in there, aren't I? I know I am. Look at that. I'm not really into ironing it this morning anyway. Don't feel like that. Isn't it terrible? It's only 2 weeks till Christmas, and it's freezing here. It's just not good. It's not good. I'm telling you now, I don't like it at all. I'm a big sook, I know, but I can't help it. Can't help myself. That's going to go there. Did we say 5 or 4.5? This is what I wrote on the piece of paper. Just mine's in a mess. I said 4 inches, didn't I? Yes. Now you're going way too fast, aren't you? Look at that. That'll be inside the crease. Very good. I hope that's straight. I might cut a bit off the bottom, because I'm thinking that's not really good. So I'm just going to cut a bit off here. And by 7. Now that would have worked if you've got to do it right to then, but I can't. But it doesn't matter, because you're not going to be able to see this once I put the piece of fabric over the top of it, are you? So there you go. You're not going to be able to see it. Now, so when this frayed, sticky thing out of there. When it frayed, obviously, that's not straight to me. I don't think it looks like it is. It must be, though. Righto. Okay, we'll go with that side. We'll pretend that that's right. 5. See how that looks like it's out there? Look at that. Alright, so that's along that line there. Okay. I don't think we're going to be too upset about it, really, because we can't afford to be fiddling around. We can sort it out in the end, can't we? We can sort it out. We can put something behind it. You know, you can put a piece of fabric behind it if it's not big enough to cover your work, your book, I should say. Now, this seems awful long. What have I got there? 7.5. Ah, dear. It does seem big, though, doesn't it, to me? Where's that other that bit of stuff? Oh, yeah. I have made it bigger. I have made it a fair bit bigger. Okay. So we're going to draw another line down here because I'm going to cut along the lines. Okay. And hopefully I'll get something that I can use. Okay. Now we've got a big mark there, but this is all going to be covered over, so... Actually, that's not the one I wanted, was it? Either this is the line here that I wanted. Got the worst pair of scissors I could have found. Why do I keep putting that there? Isn't it weird how we keep picking up the scissors that don't work? All right. I hope this is what I'm doing. It's not. Is it what I'm supposed to be doing? Ah, dear. Oh, goodness me, people, I'm so sorry. I haven't done a video for a couple of days. I've been a bit tired. I've had to go out to the hospital, have some tests done again. And it's for the, you know, things that are, you just got to go out there for tests. Otherwise, you know, there's not anywhere else. There's no sort of particular place here that we do things like that, only at the hospital that, you know. But anyway, now that's too small. Because I'm sure that this is not right. This would be cut here too. It's not going to be too small, so you're going to do it. Probably should have left it on the big piece. But then that wouldn't have worked either. Where's this? Right. So, is it still 4 inches? Yes, it's actually a bit over, so it's not too bad at all. Righto. Now the 7. Come up to there. Right. Now, this part's not hard because I'm going to show you how to do it the right way. Not my way. If you understand. So I've got lots of bits and pieces here and I'm going to decide which colours I want to use because I'm thinking I'm liking to go with I definitely want to use a piece of this, right? I definitely want a piece of this. So I'll get a piece of this. It's beautiful, isn't it? I had a beautiful blue piece and do you think I can find it? Nope. And I don't need it nowhere near that big because what I'm making is not very big, is it? Okay. So, sometimes I used to do 9 pieces in my pieces of work. It was just something that I just got into the habit of doing, where I used nine bits. We'd go with all the velvet, because cord, so it's not... Not velvet, so that'll be defeating the purpose, won't it? But I just love the colours, and I couldn't find my blue one, so I'm going to put it down there anyway. Okay, so I've got a bit of that and a bit of that, and a tiny bit of that, which only needs small bits. And there's more of that there, but I don't think I need it. The purple, 1, 2, look at that. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think that'll be enough colours, don't you reckon? Well, we'll see how we go. Right, so in the middle, I'll put the green bit. So I'm going to just cut out a triangle piece. Actually, it's not going to be a triangle. I want something with 5 sides. Okay, so you get your piece and you cut it maybe like that. Maybe you don't have to have 5 sides, but we'll see how it goes. So there's a green bit. That's got 5 bits on it, hasn't it? Okay. So there we go. There's that bit. And then, you probably see me doing a lot of this because it's got to keep it out of my way. It's got to get the fluff out of my way. So you got that piece. And then we'll put on a piece of pink. Okay. So the pink's going to go there, right? So I'm going to cut that, and I hope I do it right. So I'm going to put it on, I'm going to turn it up there like that, okay? So let's do that. We're right into it, eh? We don't want to fool around at all. Get right into the story, okay? So the first one, we probably should have pinned it. I'm going to pin here. Okay, so you want to put it along that edge, okay? And you put that up there like so. I'll probably put it that way a bit so I can just cut that off if I wanted to. So pin this. There's a issue with this too. It's not going to be... You should iron it. We should iron that down, but I think I'll be fine. I think, you know, it's up to you. If you're doing cotton and that and you iron it down, it works really good, but I don't think your velvet's going to be easy to flatten, you know? You can get velvet off lots of different things. If you can't buy it in the shops where you live, just go and get some from off a skirt or something off a out of the thrift stores or somewhere, you know. You can just get it from there. Okay. Right. Now, these are not exactly, you know, amazing, the stitches. I'm doing my best. I don't want to actually, they're good stitches. It's going to hold it on there, don't get me wrong. But now you've got both of your right sides together to do that, okay? And then that's going to go up there like so. But first, I'm going to have to work out how far I want that to go up there. I'm going to end this off anyway. Go through the back and just end it off there. Maybe you should come down a tiny bit further closer to me, so make sure I don't go out of the shot, though. I know I had my camera on angle the other day. I'm sorry about that. We need to be straight down, don't we? Now, so I cut that off, did I? Yeah, oh, no, serious. Did I end it off? It doesn't really matter if you did. It's going to be stitched on there lots of times. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut off about... there. Alright, so there's not really that much science to it. And then I'm going to cut off about here, because you want to keep that level, okay? Gotcha. Okay. Right. Now, I'm going to put that down. So you don't want the pieces to be too big, because you're only working on a little tiny thing. And that's okay. So now we can get this. Put the right sides together. This has already been sewn to something and I've pulled it off by the look of it. It's okay, nobody panic. And then that's going to go like that, but I don't know if I like this. I suppose it's all right. It's not the same as the other velvet, though. This is like a long haired sort of one. These are all velvet fabrics too. They're not, what do you call it? They're not fake. They're real. This one might be. Because you can buy ones that are stretchy. Actually, I might put... this one here next. I'm going to cut it down a bit further. So you only need little bits. And you can do this with ordinary fabric too if you want to, but I wanted to do this one today because I feel like doing some more. I love my crazy patchwork and I do love the velvet, and I'm going to, so you'd iron that, you really would, but you can push it down. Make sure you just push it right up to where the stitches are and then press it down. Okay, and then you put that on there so the right side is down. Okay, you might put a bit more cotton on the needle. That might be a good idea so we don't unthread it. Yeah. I know the cotton's here somewhere. I do this to myself every time, don't I? Oh, come on, Sonya, really? I'm covering over what I was making last time, as you can tell that. I have reels of cotton all over the house. But it's not in here. There's none in here. There's got to be. Wait a minute, I'll find a box with cotton in it. Oh, I'll have you put that one back up there too. And it's full of cotton. There's things piled up here everywhere. I never got very far with me cleaning out, did I? Oh, just got too hard. But I will get back to it, don't you worry. Fancy not me not being able to find a reel of cotton in this, all this stuff that I have in this room. I found everything else I've lost over the last few days, you know, like if you can't find something, it's got to be there somewhere. Come here, this'll do me. Got a piece of something, it'll do. Sorry about this, people. I sort of sometimes, you know how everybody says, oh yes, I'm organised, right, let's go. That doesn't necessarily happen, does it? We just, there's always something you forget. Yep. It looks like a caterpillar went along there. Okay, right, now I'll put a pin in that because I don't want it to drift about for too much, you know. So this could take a few episodes and I will be back here to do them because I really, really want to do this. I have so much stuff that's in the making. I should probably start doing a finishing. But I want to do this first and finish it. Yeah, so I know a couple of people wanted to buy that journal that I made, but I can't sell it, I'm sorry. I have an attachment to it. I think it's the best one I've ever done. And I just don't want to sell it. And I can just do more later on. Maybe next year I'll start doing some more. I'll think about it. There's a lot of work in them. Maybe I'll just make some covers or something. I don't know yet. What I'll do with this. I never know till I come in the room. Really. Because I've come in here lots of times and thought, oh, no, I don't feel like that or that or that. You know, and then you think, oh, look at that. I'll have a go at that one. I'll try some of that. I think I've got more stuff than a craft shop, so I don't have any trouble finding something to use, you know, except for me cotton, eh? Okay. I was going to go and do a bit of thrifting today. Didn't need to really, did I? So, weather's really crap, so I didn't want to go out there in the cold. It makes me miserable. I don't know about anybody else. I mean, a lot of you ladies now have got winter and that heading your way or there, whatever. And you're cold. I'm just doing a little, like, stab stitches because I know that the three thicknesses of fabric are too hard to do this in and out thing, you know. We're going to have to, well, I'm going to be putting a lot of beads, thread, because I'm doing it for the stitches. I'm going to be putting charms and lots of things like that on it, okay? It's only small, I know, but it'll still take a lot. It'll hold a fair bit. I'll probably do some ribbon embroidery on it. See, I've got a little heart there. This one hasn't got much in the way of charms and things. There's a few beads and buttons and a little bit of ribbon embroidery, only a very small piece. But on my other ones, if you've seen anything, oh, well, I can't really dig that out. I'll really make a mess. You'll see that I've put a lot of charms and things onto this sort of ones, you know, the crazy patchwork in velvet. I've got a couple of them in there that I should finish. I keep saying that, don't I? But anyway, it's good to know that I'm not the only one. Okay, right. We'll have a roll. Very handy thing to have for this. Sit there trying to pick it off with your fingers, it just does not work, does it? Right, so that's that. Okie dokie. Now, the next one I can put, I suppose, would be... Am I going the wrong way? Ooh, really? No, maybe not. I can fix that. What colour do we think? Maybe the dark colour can go in there now. So I'm going to go across here at that point there. Right? See? And then that'll open down there like that. Get me? It's covering up my good pink piece, but anyway, I'll put more pink on. So that's going to go... This should have been cut back to here. Oh, dear, that should have made it bigger, shouldn't I? It's okay. Nobody panic. We're going to put this across there, and it's going to look really awesome. when we finished. So we need it to be straight, and that's not happening, is it, yet? I don't know whether you can go one way and back the other, like as far as putting them on here. I suppose you can. Now that looks good because I can put another pink one up there, put a pink one down here. I can go crazy with the pink ones, pink pieces if I want to. So we're going to go take this so that you stitch that part there and the rest goes straight like so. Okay. And I don't know whether when I cut out the five, the bit with the five ends on it, whether I was doing the right thing there or not. I think it works. I think it works. And people do these on the machine and just sew it really fast, but you don't have to. Now, you can just sew this on the sewing machine first and then start your hand stitching, but I'm personally wanting to stitch it by hand anyway because I do enjoy hand sewing a lot more than the sewing machine. I don't know why, but I've never been partial to the sewing machine. Don't mind it if I'm making something like a, you know, if I have to make curtains or something big like that. I don't really like doing it with small pieces for some reason, so I can stitch them myself. Okie dokie. So we've still got a little bit of time left, have we? Oh, I don't remember now when I started this. I think I'm good. I don't think we've been going on here that long, have we? Yeah. Unless I just stay here and do two episodes, one after the other, one will end up quick in the other one. But I don't know. I'll have to see. So, see, going through here, I've got four lots of fabric here. So I need to... We just need to stab up and down and it'll work just nicely. And it's very calming, this, isn't it, don't you think? I went too far, so I did a backstitch. So if your book's bigger, a lot bigger, whatever you decide you want to put it on, or if you want to make a bigger panel so you can do a bag or a purse or something with it, you can do that. And then I'm going to have enough little scraps left over to make a heap more by the look of this, because I've got to cut a lot of this one now. And that's okay. You know, because if you just went and bought... Actually, sometimes you can get little kids' clothes or jacket or something, you know, that you could do it used to use them. So we got more there than I thought we were going to have. Hey, there's more than I thought. Now, I want to cut this down a bit because I want to put another colour out there. I also want to come back this way with a bit. Okay. So that's going down to there. Didn't go right to the end, Sonya. That's okay, I can cut that off anyway, can't I? Both of them can be level with one another. I'll just cut this down here a bit while I'm looking at the back of it. See what I come up with in the front. It's okay, you can sew it back together. If you make a mistake, just put it back on. Simple, really. So now I want to do a piece going across here and there and that way, right? So I'm going to cut this off here because I've got enough that way, haven't I? Plenty. I might take the pink across this way. That's because that'll fit in there, won't it? And then I've got that bit, and then I've got a bit there. Okay, well, it could fit here, could fit there and go across like that. What other colour will I need? I think I should put the yellow on. I think I should put the yellow on there. Yes, I do. Okay, so we'll just do this piece across here. That's just the right size. Okay. I hope you're following this. If you can't see what's going on, you better let me know so I can redo it or something. I'm pinching cotton out of the other needles. Actually, I don't have to do that. I can use the needle, can't I? I can use the needle and all. Before I come back here, I promise I'll find some cotton. Actually, I've got boxes of embroidery thread, and I was in here a while ago looking around the room trying to see if I could see where it was. I can't see any of it anywhere. I don't know what's going to go with that, but anyway. So I'll need a pin to go into this. And we're not doing this here, are we? Oh, are we? We'll put it there. Look at that. It fits there. Let's put it there. Righto. It'll look nice, I think. That's not the pin. This is a pin. No, that's not the pin. This is the pin. I'll get the pin in a minute. Okie dokie. Oh, that was close. Right. Up under there. Okay. I've actually got a little bit over the, gone a little bit over that one. That's okay, because it's better that you've got a little bit more, isn't it, than not having enough, eh? So you just want to keep going around and putting these patches on while they'll fit, or cutting them down to fit too. That's a good idea, you know. So I don't know how long. I did look at that clock, and I'm sure what's up to now is when I'm supposed to finish, so I mustn't have seen it. Mustn't have took very big good notice of that. I came in here at 10:30, I know that, and then I did a lot of looking about before I got started, so it's 11:30 now. So I don't know, I didn't start this straight away, so I'm going to keep going a minute. And I'll come back in and I'll show you more tomorrow, maybe. Just depends if it's a good day, I might duck out and see if there's any garage sales on or anything. See what happens. Oh, so because it got hot, I said to Jeremy, we could probably put the summer sheets on. This was today? Oh, it must have been at the beginning of the week sometime, because we'll usually change them every Wednesday. Yeah, so anyway, they were freezing. I could not get warm, no matter what I tried. Had a cover over top of me, like one of those minky blankets, because I really love to sleep with that. Not very fan of doing this no more for some reason. They seem to feel with me like I'm lifting something really heavy around all night besides myself. So I got him to do that, and it was freezing cold against my body. They are a pair of sheets that I've had forever, because they're really good quality. They're really, really good. They're a really good brand and good thread count and all that sort of thing. Still in absolutely perfect condition, and white, which I love the white sheets. But I've asked him today to please take them off, because even though I had the electric blanket on and I turned it on, I could still feel that I was really cold against them sheets. So in the summertime, I should be right. I should be laughing. I should be toast, you know, just cool as a cucumber. But I suppose I do have a few health issues, but still, I don't want to. I don't think I'll be freezing. I don't like that idea at all. It'd be really cold. Anyway, I'll cut that off there a bit. I don't want to cut my cotton. I'll get back and fix that in a minute. I just want that to come out over the end. Look, isn't that brilliant? I love that. I'm really excited. Now I'm gonna hang onto it reasonably tight. I'm gonna put a pin in it, and then I'm gonna cut the edge off, because, and then I can see what I'm up to. Righto. I should have looked underneath to make sure there's nothing else under there that I was gonna cut accidentally. I don't think there is. I've come over the edge a little bit with it, and that's all right, because there's plenty then to, you know, to move about with. So I didn't end that off, did I? Right, I might have to do that. Wait a minute, where am I up to? Okay, I'll just go and get that, stitch that bit there down. Yeah, so then went he's changed them already for me today. So he's wanting to change it, so that's good. Put it back the other way. But I don't think it's going to be the heat set. Heat will not be setting in that short space of time, I'm sure. Okay, so now I'm going to have one going like that, I think, for that corner. I reckon that'll look all right. I don't think I'll be very disappointed with that if I put that up there. Do you? I don't know if I'm keen on that colour, because I wasn't going to put that colour in. I was like, 1, 2, 3. I've got 5 colours. Okay, so what do we think about that then? I'll have a mouthful of water. This here looks really dark, doesn't it? But it's a beautiful purple. It's a beautiful purple colour. I've got green. I really did want blue. I suppose I could put this across here. You've got to catch all those. And then when it comes up there, it's going to be like a little triangle on the top as well. That's easy. But I'll go down here and show you something down this other end and see what we can put down this other way, because we need to have it going in different directions, don't we? You know, like, it's okay. Don't worry. You'll understand, even though I'll probably make things hard for you to understand. I'm sure you will. So do I need to put another colour? I'm going to need another colour or not. I don't want red. I don't think. It does make things look really dual, doesn't it? Dual colours there, the red does. Lifts it along, doesn't it? Right. All there. Oh. I might put that on there. I've used it on other pieces before. We've used the red, haven't we? So I'm just going to stitch it on and then I'll cut it off what I don't need. I should have got hubby to bring me in some cotton while I know he was just out there a while ago. Okay, this is not good. I've got me... So I've got my thread here and I'm going to use a bit of this. White. I'm going to use a bit of this to start with because I can't find me reels of cotton. That's not good. See, when you put things away, it's too hard to find them again, isn't it? I painted my poor old fingernails today because they were making me... actually making me sick, but it was just... Some of them are growing along all right. Thinking of going about getting nice ones for Christmas. I don't know. I don't really want to go back to that place. There's a couple of other places in the town that I found, so I don't know. I'll have to see what happens there. I might have to cut a bit off this. I might think it might be just a bit too big to work with. This is not as thick as the other ones. So there's all different sorts, you know, that you can get. Well, I think that looks amazing. That does look really ducky, doesn't it? We'll put it on there. And we probably will be putting on some laces and some braids. I know I'm going to use some vintage lace on here if I can. If I can find it. It's not a very big piece, is it, to put all this stuff on. But you don't want to start on too big a piece. You know, sometimes it's very daunting if you get something that's too big to do. I was going to just get you to make little panels, but then you'd have to put them together afterwards. So how about we just do it first place and get it right? It's only a small piece. It's only a small piece. Move that back a bit. Now, make sure you keep your right sides together and you just do it this way, okay? If you just follow what I'm doing, it should work for you. Nah. And then you get cobbled up here too, don't you, in the pin. Got him. Okay. Yeah, I was going to go shopping. But anyway, I've got things I have to get before Christmas, you see. You just have to do this thing. And if you leave everything to the last minute, then it's all gone. Because we don't have many choices of places to go around here. I'm looking for a nice cutlery set. Do you think I could find what I wanted? I would not want just silver. I don't want black, you know, on the handle. There was one that was clear, sort of. And I didn't like that either. So I don't know what I'm looking for. Gold one. That was a bit... Sorry about that. The gold one might have been a little bit over the top. It actually wasn't real gold. It was just like a gold... Yes, so Yes, a gold. But anyway, I'll find something. There's only me and Jeremy here most of the time, and I just want one that I can put away that we can just use, you know, sometimes. I have the same spoon. I like to use the same spoon. I have my own breakfast plate. I have my own cup. Only because you get used to these things, I suppose. Now, where am I going to go? To the end of there. Okay. And then I have dinner sets that I have put away for, you know, use of when people come along. I have my own bowl too. Actually, they're all, I use any ones of the bowls, but I usually have my lunch in a bowl. I will not eat anything out of plastic or drink anything out of plastic. I didn't know, that's because of something. Of course, when I was a kid, I suppose we had plastic. So I don't want to do that. Yes, so I don't have to, do I? I have to use a glass with a handle on it so I can get a hold of it properly when I'm in water. You've probably seen me using them. They're like a beer. They're like beer glasses people buy to put their beer in, I think. And I just buy them because I like to hang on to the handle. I have to have a handle on it to get hold of it properly. But anyway, so there's a little bit more business about me. You probably didn't want to know, but anyway. Anyhow. I don't know whether I should cut that back a bit and give myself a bit more space to put some more colour in there. I'm having a bit of a look at this and thinking, what am I going to do next? Because I think I've done this the wrong way. I think you're supposed to just keep going round and round and round. I don't think you're supposed to go off into the centre of it in any way, because I don't think I'm going to patch it. I'll figure it out, though. I'm not going to be daunted by it or whatever. I'll be put off by that at all. But I definitely have to have this colour here now, don't I? And then it comes down there, and then where does that go? So you've got to think about that. So I'll get the bigger piece. I've got a big piece, I can do it. Now if I put it there, across here, right, put it across to there, and then flip it down like that, and then you've got, I'll figure out how to fix that. I will figure out how to fix that. Okay, when we get there, we'll fix it. Because I think I've gone one way and back the other, I think, on it, and I shouldn't have done that. So we'll just work on this. Oh dear, oh dear. Well, this is very fluffy, isn't it? Oh dear. Goodness me. Oh, I had to throw away this really good blanket yesterday. Actually, we didn't. We gave it to the dog. Oh, well, it will be the dog's blankets. Jeremy's making blankets for the dog out of it, you know, because she needs blankets. So, because it was covered in cat hair and we couldn't get it off. The cat used to sleep on it in the spare room and we couldn't get the... I'm gonna stitch this down. And we couldn't get the cat hair off it. We put it on the line for a couple of months to see if that would help. And... because it was a good, it wasn't new or anything, but it still wasn't nothing wrong with it, and we just couldn't get the fluff off it. So we're going to give it to the pup. She didn't like it. She will. We've got a tiny little chihuahua thing, terrier thing, and she, well, you would have seen it on the videos anyway, and she will love that fluffy thing for her in the wintertime in the shed. So, yeah, so we're going to, I forgot what I was saying now about the blanket. Oh, about the fluff on the blanket. I couldn't believe it was that bad, but the cat must have been... Now I have a cover on the bed so he can't... Whatever he puts up there, it's just on a cotton thing, so it's all right. But he doesn't get on there anymore. He sleeps with us now. That's weird. They do things like that to you, don't they? You can't save them from much because they do them sort of things to you. I thought I was going to save... It's okay with mine. We're just vacuuming that off, but... can't use the other one in the spare room anymore, but I've got enough things. I love blankets, and I'm always buying blankets and covers and things. I just love them for some reason. Don't use them a lot. Just like buying them. Okay, so that's a bit skew-whiff, isn't it? What have I done now to myself? Well, I can make it into a shape, can't I? Yes, righto. You're hoping I'm not going to quit now, and you're because I do that. I get to a difficult part, and then I give up. But I'm not going to do that today. I'm going to put this in here somewhere, okay, and figure out how I can help you and me put it together properly, okay? Did I make a knot? Probably not. I didn't. Rightio. Mm-hmm. Right, so... I was going to say that it's a queen-size blanket, this thing. It's a great big minky blanket that my youngest daughter bought for me. I don't think she watches my channel. A long time ago. And it's her dog. It used to be her dog, so she won't mind if it's sleeping on it. Jeremy's going to cut it into sections for her so she can have it, because we have to change them a bit on it because she gets them caught up, and it's best to keep it nice and clean. And, you know, they're babies after all, these animals, aren't they? They're like babies. Right, so what can I do with this? How can I fix this? What have I done to myself? You reckon I can fix it? I hope so. I haven't got the bit up there yet, have I? Okay, am I still in the shot? Oh, my goodness me, I'm so sorry. Oh, dear. I'm just going to keep that as a square for a while because I want to see what will happen with it. I'm going to put this across here. Then I want another bit down there too because I love the pink. I don't think that's going to fit though, look. No. So you try that first, right? You've got to make sure that it's going to fit in there. But I have a lot of this, so I can do that. I can safely say that that won't not go either. Where's another bit? Put it down here on the floor. You'd be hoping that I got enough. I think I did. You'd be hoping that I got enough. Mm-hmm. Now it's going to have to go across all those pieces. I probably should have stitched that down too, but I didn't. And it is on an angle. I cut it on an angle, not purposely. And there's not going to be a lot of that. You know, it looks like it's going to be a lot of that there, but it's not. It might be a good idea if I end this off here first. I go to the next piece. I might have to go now because I think my time might be up. I was really having fun doing this, okay? I'll come back to fair where I finished, okay? So if you want to try yours and get, you know, keep putting them on, and I will figure out this, it'll be fine. I mean, if you've got to put a piece in there that you turn over like that on there, and you can make it like that so it goes in there like so, it will work. And if it doesn't, we'll cover it up with something else. There's always something. But see, people used to put their clothes together like this because, not their, well, their bits of old clothing and that, to make things, to make covers, didn't they, for beds and stuff like that. Pillows and things, pillowcases and stuff. I do like that. I'm excited. I'm going to be... So if you want to get your bits and pieces together, you don't have to have the velvet. You can, if you can find like pieces of fabric like this that are shiny, I suppose, you can even use your cotton fabric if you want to. And this wasn't put together like this is. This was one of my crazy ways that I just put it together. So that's why I know I can fix this, because I just put the patches on till they fit. And it didn't matter which way they really went. This has got a few little bubblies in it, but that doesn't matter because you're going to be stitching all in there and around and about, okay? So thank you, everybody, for watching, and I hope you've all been safe, and have a good day, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.